Okay, that looks really painful. And online, while doing my research, that particular condition you just saw, which we're going to be talking about, it's called scabies, and it's also referred to colloquially as a seven-year itch.
I know. I'm starting to feel a bit itchy right now after looking at those visuals.
Let us stay a little bit away from you.
Today we're going to find out more about scabies?
Yeah, we're going to find out a bit about scabies, and it's actually classified by the World Health Organization as a water-related disease.
Water-related disease.
Now, it may be transmitted from objects, but it's most commonly transmitted by direct skin-to-skin contact, which is why I'm not giving you any more advice.
I'm going to trust you on that. Anyway, hey, you know what? I've always thought that scabies are kind of related to bed bug bites.
Yeah.
They kind of look similar.
They look similar.
Why don't we find out by speaking to the specialist himself we have in the studio. Welcome aboard to Dr. Raj of the dermatology. He's the dermatology specialist of Hospital Tengku Angkuan Rahima Klang. Welcome to the studio. And how are you today?
Good? All mine. I'm good.
Yeah? Do you deal with this on a daily basis?
On a daily basis, yes. On a daily
basis. So it's that prevalent?
Daily basis.
Okay, so it sounds pretty common.
It's very common.
Okay, all right. How can we contract this disease?
I would say direct contact 99% of the time from the objects that you mentioned earlier, probably just 1%. Yeah, but 99% is direct human-to-human transmission.
So these are bugs. These are mites.
Mites.
All right. How do we know when a particular object or person is infected with this so we can avoid the contact?
You won't be able to see those mites because they're microscopic. There are certain signs that you can actually look out for that might actually give you an indication that person might be having scabies. For example, itch. Okay, I think that's the major symptom. Intractable itch. I'm not sure whether it's called a 7-year itch. It reminds me of the Marilyn Monroe movie. I think the local term for it is kulis buta. I'm sure everyone has, a lot of us have experienced relatives or students coming back from hostels or from university, and they have this itch and rash, especially over their wrists, the soles of the body, the armpits, the groin area, usually in between your fingers.
So what we're looking at on the screen looks very severe compared to what we're actually talking about. Why did the condition escalate to those proportions?
I think based on that image, we usually don't see a very severe case like that. It's usually limited in skin fold areas. The mites don't like open areas where they can be discovered and they can be brushed off or scratched off your body. So they actually hide in all those wet spaces and in those skin fold areas. But in a condition like that, when the mites actually become, they multiply and they become florid, will usually indicate an underlying immunocompromised state. So your immune system is not really up to that normal level. So someone with probably a retroviral infection, HIV/AIDS, someone who's on long-term steroids, patients with diabetes, then the mites just proliferate and they go all over.
Wow.
But those are very extreme cases. The usual cases that we see every day would be children, teenagers, interdigital web spaces, and skin folds.
Well, okay, I've got a question. See, when we look at this visual right here, I just wonder, does the mite bite you and does it go away, or it does something? Does it lay eggs? Or
It does. It actually lives on fish
bones.
Yes, it jumps onto your skin, and then it burrows into your skin. And it starts off distally, further away from you, and then it starts, crawling towards nearer and nearer.
So it becomes a scabby nest.
Sort of,
yeah.
So you become the host, and they actually feed on your skin. They don't actually feed directly off your from your blood.
Okay.
I mean, as compared to bed bugs, bed bugs actually feed from your blood.
Okay.
They actually start your blood, but scabies, no, they just burrow into your skin. They see us, and you know, the dead cells, and they multiply, and they lay eggs.
That's scary.
And yeah. It's
any chance some stir fried lontong might draw them away? And
unfortunately, no.
So what actually gets them out of your body, basically?
You need treatment. You need treatment. There are no tablets. There are no injections. You need lotions and creams.
Lotion and creams.
Yes.
All right.
There are several types available in private hospitals, in government hospitals, even in the pharmacy. But you need to know what. There are only certain types of lotions and creams that are suitable for certain age groups.
Okay.
Yeah. But lotions and creams, no tablets, no injections. Tablets only for itching, but it doesn't kill off the mites.
So, what you do is you go to a pharmacist.
If you suspect, if you suspect that you might have scabies, I think it's best to actually get it checked out. See a dermatologist, see a doctor instead of just buying medication off the counter, because there are a lot of conditions that can actually mimic scabies. It could be eczema,
yes,
you know, an allergic reaction.
Yeah, an itch can just be an itch. 7-year itch might be a problem, but an itch may not just be the symptom we're looking for. What are the other symptoms that you know can really indicate scabies?
Okay, one would be the rash at those specific areas. And once you start scratching, then you're going to like injure the skin, and then that's going to cause a lot of infection,
scars,
infection, and then you get bacterial infection. It's going to be like really weepy and oozy, and so you're looking for those signs as well. And then you're going to look for burrows. So these are like linear, straight lines, you know, not just circular, reddish. Spots, but this would be like linear lines that would actually indicate the burrows that the mites actually use to crawl up.
Oh, that's
nasty.
Unbearable. Yes, to think about.
Yeah, nasty is the best word to describe.
Prevention. What can we do in case we have children? We want to keep them away from these mites. Keep the house, the living place, as clean as possible. How can we do that? Do they attack beds, objects?
They do not attack beds. Bed bugs comparatively actually live in beddings. They live in upholstery, and they crawl out when there's a warm body on it, and then they bite and they suck your blood, and then they go back into hiding.
Yes.
The scabies mite doesn't live on those inanimate objects, but they actually live on you. So, I think hygiene is the first and foremost attention that we need to do. Proper hygiene, and to have a high index of suspicion, especially when somebody comes from the nursery with a rash. I think of something like scabies first. It's not to say that you're not going to shake hands with him, or, you know, but. it's prolonged continuous contact, because we see patients with scabies every day, but you know, so far I'm not sure none of the doctors have contracted scabies, so it's prolonged continuous contact with an infected person.
So as long as I don't spend too much time with you, I'm fine.
Alright, thank you for
I'm just kidding, bro.
And they have it, you know, limit on scabies today here on the show. And thank you so much, Dr. Raj, for enlightening up the whole scenario of me not having any.
Thank you, Doctor. If anyone watching this program right now has some of the symptoms that we've been talking about, where should they go?
See a doctor.
Right. So any general practitioner will be fine?
Any general practitioner, you can go to a general hospital, you can go to a clinic, you can go to a private hospital, but I think it's important to actually let a doctor look at the rash, because there's so many things that can cause an itch, a reddish rash, spots. So you want to know whether this is an infective cause or a non-infective cause. I think that's the most important thing.
We have a few callers on the line, unfortunately. We have not enough time to answer your questions, but thank you for calling anyway. You know, perhaps next time, just jump in on the phone line before we get started talking. So thank you very much for tuning in.